sometimes I let it sit for weeks, months, years, live with it, and then I get idea of what to do with it. I'm Lucien Samaha. I am a photographer, visual artist. I sometimes call myself a post-conceptual artist because instead of thinking of a project, I like to go out and gather data in the world. I collect vernacular photography. Part of my photographic practice is this passion for older photographs, vintage photographs, and I happen to have a really beautiful family archive that I got from my mother that used to be in a shoebox for a long time. Recently, in the last few years, started buying old photographs in flea markets. Like, I go to Romania a lot, I go to Istanbul, and I go to the flea markets there. And sometimes I have time to sort through them. I put them in categories or various different genres. There's drawers for Polaroids. These are all like done by years. There's slides. I never throw anything away, and I don't delete any photographs because a photograph that I didn't like 20 years ago, I might love today. And in fact, there are photographs that were so badly out of focus that I imagine that someday somebody will create an application that will bring it back to focus. So that's why I don't delete anything. These are gonna be in the show. These are my point-and-shoot digital cameras that I've used throughout the years. This is the first one I had bought. It was in the year 2000. When the first digital camera came out, a lot of people were like, ew, this doesn't look good. Look at all this grain, look at these artifacts, look at these pixels. To me, that was lovely. That was something new. That was something that was different from what we were seeing. And that's why I kind of embraced digital photography right away, because I could create things that nobody else was doing. Most recently, I've been doing this series of portraits of friends of mine who died of AIDS. The whole idea is that these young men suffered so much that this technique kind of shows them a little bit bleeding or sweating or crying in a way. When I first make them, I hang them over here, and as you can see, they're still dripping. And sometimes when there's a lot of ink coming down, I'll put a piece of napkin and then I'll hold it here so it absorbs. And in a way, it's a little bit of the mourning process for me, mourning as in mourning somebody's death. Most of them I had lost touch with, and only when I came back to New York and started asking, where's Michael, where's Frankie, and I would hear they died, you know. So I never really got to mourn them. So this process, this project, and this process of me like attending to them regularly as I'm making the prints is kind of part of my dealing with that whole tragedy.